On April 12, 1861, the Confederate States decided to blast Fort Sumter with cannonballs. Fort Sumter was a man-made island with 68 starving men inside. This conflict lasted for 2 days, and the reason why the Confederate States decided to blast Fort Sumter with cannonballs instead of fire was because it was off the coast of South Carolina, which was a Confederate state. Some of the battle strategies used by the North were to keep General Lee from entering Washington, D.C. and to invade the South. Some of the Southern battle strategies were Pickett's charge, which the Confederates hoped to destroy it. It happened during the Battle of Gettysburg. The South also invaded the North. A field hospital is the last place you would want to go in the Civil War. Why? I'll tell you about the surgeons. First, the surgeons, doctors, put highly explosive chloroform in the funnel over your mouth and fed it to you so you could fall asleep. Then they used their dirty hands and dirty scissors and a lot of sharp knives to amputate the arm or leg. The field hospitals were usually located in tents to help the air flow. During the Civil War, they thought that diseases were caused by bad air. The nurses in the field hospitals did a lot for the soldiers and didn't wear hoops in their skirts. Fun fact, Harriet Tubman was also a nurse. As I explained before, the people during the Civil War thought diseases were caused by bad air. Bad air is air that stinks. So the surgeons cleaned up the hospitals a lot, but their hands were still dirty. Since their hands were dirty, diseases spread easily, and anyone in the hospital was exposed. Keep this in mind, two out of three people died by disease than in battle. During the Civil War, soldiers used a lot of weapons. They used cannons like the Napoleon. Soldiers also used bayonets or powerful guns, artillery, such as the Springfield and the Sherrill combined. One more thing they used were mines to break into the enemy forts.